What if you could take a pill that improved your productivity at work? And what if that pill were free? Oh, and what if it made you feel really good and improved your overall health? No such pill exists, but science suggests an alternative does: sleep. In today's globalized, hyper-connected, hustle work culture, we're often spending longer hours working, frequently at the cost of our sleep. Sleep is pretty weird. Evolutionarily, sleep is a ridiculously stupid thing because we're out cold for some time, where any predator could come and kill us while we're completely defenseless. But for some reason, evolution has decided that these risks are totally worth it and that the benefits of sleep far outweigh being blind, paralyzed, and defenseless for a third of our lives. It may seem obvious that sleep is both beneficial and important, but I'd never really given much thought about how to sleep better and more productively, until years back when I lost the ability to sleep efficiently. Even without fully grasping what sleep does for us, we know that going without sleep for too long makes us feel terrible, and that getting a good night's sleep can make us feel ready to take on the world. Evidence suggests that a good night's sleep seriously boosts productivity. Yet paradoxically, what is the main driver of poor sleep? Work overload. So many of us are not getting enough sleep because we're working too much, and we're not working efficiently because we're not getting enough sleep. Sound like a bad cycle? In this video, I'm going to talk about sleep from two perspectives. One, on why you should sleep better, and two, on ways to sleep better, which you can apply to your life immediately. So before I talk about how to actually sleep productively, we need to be sold on why sleeping better is actually important. Hi, I'm Rishi, and thanks for stopping by my channel. I'm a practicing nutritionist with a background in human physiology and nutritional sciences. Here, I take a holistic and scientific approach to all aspects of health and wellness. I use food and lifestyle changes to optimize one's nutrition to promote longevity and healthy aging. So if you want to hack your health span and be the best version of yourself, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you don't miss anything. Why do we sleep anyway? Although scientists aren't entirely sure why we sleep, they have many ideas about the functions of this mysterious part of our lives. While some of these functions may have deep evolutionary roots, others, such as sleep's potential role in memory and health, seem particularly relevant to life in today's world. Firstly, one of the key points is that we all actually kind of need more sleep. There's this epidemic of people not sleeping 7+ hours a night, and this attitude of, oh, I'll sleep when I'm dead, and I only need 5 to 6 hours of sleep every night to function perfectly fine. There's a ton of evidence showing that if you chronically sleep for less than 7 to 8 hours a night, you're screwing yourself in various domains of life. Yes, apparently there are people who can sleep for less than 6 hours each night and function completely fine without any issues, but those are less than 1% of the population. So if you think you're in that camp, great. I certainly am not. Secondly, even if you feel we're all right when we get 6 hours of sleep a night, apparently the evidence shows that we are pretty bad at assessing our own performance and function while sleep deprived. So while being sleep deprived, we think we're totally fine. That's why we should aim for 8 hours a night, and if we don't, it can lead to all sorts of issues further down the line. Studies show getting quality sleep on a regular basis can help improve all sorts of issues, from mind, body, and heart health to your blood sugar and your workouts. Here's a quick dive into 7 ways that quality sleep benefits your life and health span. Number 1, sharper brain and memory. Sleep and work performance go hand in hand. Sleep improves concentration and cognitive function, keeping your focus on point all day. Sleep plays a big part in learning and memory too. It allows your brain to hit the save button on your day to create long-term memories. Sleep provides a time when the brain's synapses, the connections between neurons, shrink by nearly 20%, causing the brain to shrink and letting the neurons rest and prep for the next day. Without this reset, known as synaptic homeostasis, synapses could become overloaded and burned out, like an electrical outlet with too many appliances plugged into it. The cerebrospinal fluid then steps in to clear out all the waste and toxins from the brain. This reduces inflammation and prevents dementia. Number 2, mood management. Another thing that your brain does while you sleep is process your emotions. A lack of sleep at night can make you cranky the next day, and over time, skimping on sleep can mess up more than just your morning mood. Your mind needs this time in order to recognize and react the right way. When you cut that short, you tend to have more negative emotional reactions and fewer positive ones. And a chronic lack of sleep can also raise the chance of having a mood disorder, making you 5 times more likely to develop depression, anxiety, or panic disorders. Number 3, a healthier heart. Sleep reduces blood pressure, giving your heart and blood vessels a bit of a rest. The less you sleep, the longer both your blood pressure and stress hormone cortisol stay elevated during a 24-hour cycle. This increases chances of heart disease. Number 4, athletic performance and balance. Sleep affects all types of exercise performance. It promotes physical recovery in the body. As you sleep, your body tissues repair, grow and strengthen while producing its muscle-building hormones of testosterone and growth hormone. Further, it helps with hand-eye coordination and reaction time. Number 5, steadies blood sugar. During the deep, slow wave sleep, blood glucose drops. Not enough time in this deepest stage means you don't get that reset. This can negatively affect blood sugar levels and insulin sensitivity, making you more susceptible to developing type 2 diabetes over time. Number 6, immune health and inflammation. Sleep regulates your immune system. When you don't get enough sleep, inflammation can result. Chronic inflammation keeps the immune system in overdrive, increasing your risk of autoimmune disorders and other health issues. Plentiful sleep allows your immune cells the rest they need to fight off whatever harmful bacteria and viruses come their way. Number 7, weight control. When you're well rested, you're less hungry. Sleep deprivation imbalances your appetite control hormones by increasing ghrelin, which makes you hungry, and lowering leptin, which tells you you're full. It also increases your stress hormone cortisol, making you hold on to fat. And being tired makes you less active as well. Together, this is a recipe for putting on weight. If you want to sleep better, then hit that like button so you do. Section 2, how can we sleep better? Here, I want to talk about the 12 practical steps you can implement to make yourself sleep better. Rule number 1, set a sleep schedule and try to sleep and wake up at the same time every day. Be consistent with your sleep times. This applies even more so on the weekends when people tend to sleep later and wake up later. It's a hard one to implement, but the more consistent your sleep times, the better it's going to be for your overall productivity. Rule number 2, don't use alarms if you can help it. Alarms cause a huge stress response when we wake, and we can all relate to that phone alarm as the worst sound in the world. Snoozing is worse, as we get that repeated stress trauma every single morning. Personally, I set my phone alarm to vibrate only. Rule number 3, wake up with the sun or use very bright lights. This helps set our circadian rhythm and helps set our body clock that it's the daytime and time to be awake. Rule number 4, avoid all caffeine and nicotine completely, if at all possible. But if you enjoy having caffeine like I do, then aim to stop having it at least 10 hours before sleeping. Rule number 5, exercise regularly. Because exercising regularly helps us with our sleep and is generally good for us. But avoid exercising within 3 hours of bedtime. Rule number 6, avoid napping during the day. It apparently makes it harder to sleep properly at night. I'm not much of a napper myself, but napping spoils your sleep appetite. Like having a snack before dinner ruins your meal's appetite. Rule number 7, alcohol. Alcohol is one of the most powerful suppressors of REM, rapid eye movement sleep, or your dream sleep. And if you have it in any reasonable time before sleeping, it's definitely going to affect your sleep quality. The annoying advice of abstinence is the best and most honest one I can offer. For me personally, alcohol totally wrecks my sleep. And for this reason, I gave it up a little while back and it's been a total game changer. Won't lie. Rule number 8. Avoid large meals at least 3 hours before you sleep at night. Eating a large meal before sleeping does make us feel sleepy, but it definitely affects the quality of our sleep. Rule number 9. Reduce lights before sleep. Blue light is particularly harmful. Ideally, in the evening, replace bright LEDs with warm yellow glows to avoid blue light at nighttime, especially the ones coming from our phones and devices. Use the blue light filter instead. Rule number 10, cool your body temperature before sleeping. The ideal temperature for sleeping is 65 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 18.3 degrees Celsius, which is actually pretty cold. And anecdotally speaking, I sleep so much better when my room is chilled. And when it's warm, it's straight up impossible for me to fall asleep. Rule number 11, don't rely on sleeping pills. Those are generally bad and they don't really help with our sleep. Instead, the person is in a state of sedation, which isn't the same as sleep. And so, we don't get the benefits of sleep. And finally, rule number 12 is, don't lie in bed awake trying to fall asleep for more than 20 minutes. This is something that I struggled with a lot before I started taking care of my sleep, stressing about why I can't fall asleep. This only increases stress and anxiety, which paradoxically makes it even harder to fall asleep. Instead, just get out of bed and do something for a few minutes or read a book until you fall sleepy again. If you're not sleeping well, then hit that like button so you do. In a time where normalcy and routine have been replaced with sheer survival mode, people are becoming increasingly mindful of maintaining the same levels of productivity in their new ways of working and living. With many of us working from home while also taking care of young children or elderly family members, it can sometimes be difficult to stay focused and perform at 100%. While people are striving for productivity, it is important to be aware of the role that health, specifically sleep health, plays. There is no substitute for sleep. As we navigate the new normal and aim to maintain productivity, sleep is crucial and gives the brain and body the necessary tools to perform at optimal levels every day. By prioritizing sleep, we can not only improve performance, but also overall holistic well-being. Until we move toward valuing sleep and its productivity-boosting potential as a cultural norm, you can at the very least value it for yourself, and your productivity, and your health. Thanks for watching this video. If you found value in the information I've shared, then please consider subscribing and hitting that like button. Drop me a comment if you have any feedback for me,